If you are managing a network in a place where you want to limit the physical devices that are allowed to connect to one of your switches, then most likely you will need to configure port security. It is this idea that you control access through MAC addresses. Take public library as an example. There are certain devices like computers and printers that need network access, so you will have some Ethernet patch panels or wall sockets for this purpose. But there is no way for you to prevent someone just walking up, unplugging the printer, and trying to use the Ethernet cable for internet, if not something worse. On the router, you can set up firewall rules, and even better, you could have a .1x server setup. .1x uses EAP authentication to verify if you're allowed to have access, so it is better than gatekeeping based on addresses alone. But assuming that all you have is a switch, if you want to cut off the wrong devices before they have a chance to try and do anything, you'll want to use ACL rules. They're like firewall rules, but they run on the switch chip, so they won't tax the CPU. And then you probably will want to change some bridge settings to further harden the security. This is what we'll do here. I have HEX-S plugged into either one of my switch, and we want to make sure that only this one particular MAC address is respected, so that when I replace it with the other HEX, there should be no meaningful communication taking place beyond the Ethernet link getting established. To do this, I will first copy the HEX-S MAC address from neighbor's list. Then I need to go to the switch rule table and add a couple of new entries. The first one needs to simply accept frames from our chosen MAC address. And of course, we want to make sure that it is for our specific port. We don't have to do anything else for this rule. Without configuring for a specific action in the Actions tab, this will work as an accept rule. If we add more MAC addresses for other devices that need to be accepted on this or other ports, we could just add them as additional rules after this one. With only one device, all we need is a rule that drops everything that did not get accepted, just like with firewall rules. But again, there is no drop action here, so what you have to do is create a rule that filters for everything in this port, and then in the Action tab, set a new destination port without specifying an actual interface. That is how you create a drop rule on the switch chip. Now, any data that comes in this port from an unknown MAC address is going to get discarded. With the HEX-S connected, everything works fine. We have IP communication. But if we switch over, nothing. It does not show up in the neighbors, and even if I knew its address and tried to manually ping it, it wouldn't work, because any frames coming in from it get dropped. This is probably a good enough port security configuration for most people. But there is one more issue we could address here. Our network could still send some data to the port with the unwanted device, exposing a little bit of information here and there. You could disable neighbor discovery for this port on the switch, but the switch sending information about itself is not the worst thing. Other devices on the network might be emitting frames into the broadcast domain that end up transported into the unrecognized device as well, so we could change some bridge port settings. Let's set the learn attribute to no. Technically, new MAC learning should not be happening if you're dropping all incoming frames from unknown addresses. But there could be ways in which new entries could get added, resulting in the switch directing frames towards some unwanted MAC address. So to be strict about what devices are allowed, we want to disable learning. Then we want to disable unknown unicast flood. It is a feature where the switch is allowed to emit a unicast frame from all of its switched ports if it does not have a host table entry for the particular MAC address. This should not be used on a port that is meant for a single known device. Now for best security, I will disable two more features, unknown multicast flood and broadcast flood, because I don't want devices on my network leaking information to an untrusted device. But this will, however, break some protocols, so be mindful of that. If you suddenly realize that something is not working on your trusted device, then it is most likely the disabled broadcast flood option causing this. DHCP and neighbor discovery are two that rely on broadcasting to the whole network. So decide for yourself how strict you want to be with port settings. Now, on whatever you settle with, if you disable MAC learning for a port, you then have to manually add the MAC address of your trusted device to the bridge host table. If the ACL rule determined which MAC can talk to the switch, then the host table determines if the switch is able to talk back. Just go to the host tab in the bridge window, add a new entry and paste in the MAC address. Just make sure the correct port is selected. These are the most important considerations for port security. There is one more thing you might want to look for when working with ACL rules. There are several routerless features that can add rules dynamically, and they can interact with the rules that are added by the user. For example, if I enable the roam on feature, it adds an ACL rule, but it is placed below our drop rule, so obviously it won't work. Moving the dynamic rule to the top will allow this feature to work correctly, but then an untrusted device might use this feature too. So think for yourself, everything has its trade-offs, and ACL rules are pretty blunt in their functionality. But I hope you learned something useful, and I didn't just confuse you for no reason.